Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today I wanted to discuss some of the new features in Apple Photos in the latest operating system of Monterey. Monterey? I don't know. Here we go. One of the biggest things that I found scrolling through Apple's website is the ability to import older photo libraries into an existing photo library. You have to ask yourself, why was this never a feature before? But it really is nice. So now you can take multiple Apple photo libraries or iPhoto libraries, according to Apple, and merge them without having to use third-party software or weird workarounds, all of that. I will say that you need to be on the latest operating system. And if you're not, I do have another video that I'll link down below that shows you how to merge multiple Apple photo libraries together. But going forward, if you are able to upgrade to the latest operating system, you can actually import that just from the file menu, and we'll walk through that step. Now, first, let's actually go out to Apple's website, and we're going to go to Mac because I want to show you the system requirements for Monterey. I like to click on Monterey in the top right. And then here is where we're able to scroll down and see all of the different features for the new operating system. Now, if I click on all new features, I can then click on learn how to upgrade. And this is going to show me the compatibility models for your computer. So before you get excited that you can merge all of your Apple Photo libraries with what you have right now, you may find out, like I did with my older laptop, that it cannot run the latest operating system. But luckily with this computer, I can upgrade, therefore I can do it. Now, if we go back to all new features, some of the features that they've quietly updated are the memories. They added more information in the info pane that's linked with the visual lookup, which is nice. They supposedly say that it's faster iCloud Photos library initial sync. We will cross that bridge when we get there and see if that actually is a thing. But this, when I saw this, I was pretty excited to be able to import photos from another photo libraries. You can now import original photos, including edits from a second photos library or third or fourth or fifth, so on and so forth. They've changed some other things that I have yet to really go in depth, but just playing with it, it doesn't seem all that new. It's pretty much the same, but I specifically wanted to make this video in regards to importing other libraries because I know a lot of people end up with different older computers or photo libraries that they want to merge together. Now, I have photos closed, and if you ever want to know what photo libraries you have on your computer, if I hold down Option on the keyboard and click on Photos, it's going to pop up a chooser to choose which library I want to open with, but it also gives me options to create a new library. Now, I have three different libraries here. One of them is my system photo library, and it says that here, and that's the one that syncs with iCloud. You can only have one library that syncs with iCloud. So this is my main master, my go-to one that syncs with my phone, my iPad, my other computers. But these other two here are older libraries that I have that may have photos that exist in the current one. I have no idea. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open up my main photos library. And this is all of my pictures. And I'm gonna go up to the file menu, choose import, and I'm gonna navigate to the pictures folder where those libraries are at. And here is that old library. I'm gonna say now review for import. So if I click on this, it now shows up on the left-hand side, says old photo library. And here it actually detected that out of all the photographs, there's already 11 of them imported in this library. So it recognized the duplicates. And then new photos, it recognizes 104. Now with that, these pictures may be in there. I'm still skeptical that Apple Photos is really good at detecting duplicates, and I'll show you why in a second. But overall, these pictures, it tells me, are not in here. So what I'm gonna do is just click on import all new photos in the top right. It's going to skip those 10 that were already there. And then it's going to import and copy all of the new ones into that library, resulting in merging two different libraries together. When it's done, I can delete that other one, and mission accomplished. So now all of those photographs are imported. If I scroll down, I can see them all here. Now, if I go up to file, let's repeat the process. Let's see if it detects the duplicates. I'm gonna do import. We're gonna import that old library again, review for import. And it found new photos, 20 photos. Okay, let's import those again. Maybe I missed that for some odd reason, but it said 104 here. So let's scroll down. It still thinks that those 20 pictures are not imported. If I select this library again, review for import, those 20 pictures here, let's just for fun import that one, even though it's right here, which it imported. Just for fun, let's go to File, Import, go to Old Photo Library, Review for Import, and again, it still shows the 20. So I will say that possibly my first video that I'll link below again, that may be your best choice, because Apple, even though you've allowed me to import them, it's most likely going to have duplicates. I have another photo library here. That's JFELD photo. Let's review that for import. So it actually found them, but it still allows you to import ones that you've already imported. And I've also noticed that if I go and just manually drag this in here, it does recognize the duplicate. That's nice. So I'm going to choose don't import. Let's try another one here. Let's do this one. All right. So dragging it in. Now let's just say import. Let's see what happens if I drag it in again. It does say import. Go back to the old library, and it still sees those 20 pictures. So I don't know whether or not to trust Apple Photos. It could be a bug in the system because it's so new. Let me know what your experiences are down in the comments. Do you experience the same thing that I do? Because what's odd is the other library recognizes the duplicates, this one doesn't. If I drag a photograph from the desktop, let's take this one for example. If we drag this in, it will import that photograph. Let's just drag it in again. And it does detect the duplicate there, so perfect, don't import. So I guess in the grand scheme of things, thank you Apple for allowing us to import the existing photo libraries, but based off of this demonstration, it doesn't seem to prove that it may be 100% reliable. In the case that it's not, I will link another video for finding duplicates just in case, which is helpful because I know there's some nice third-party tools. So if you do have duplicates after you do merge some of these libraries, you can go ahead and watch that video and let me know what you think. But overall, it is nice that it is a new feature. Hopefully it will get better. Maybe I just have a corrupt library that I don't know, and it will be perfect in the next update. Who knows? So again, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, hit that little like button. If you want to support the channel, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.